CIET-NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 8.
Hello children, how are you? Hope you are doing well. Today I am going to take up a lesson from NCERT's English textbook for class 8. The title of the book is Honeydew, Unit 2, and the name of the lesson is The Tsunami. I am Professor Kirti Kapoor from NCERT, New Delhi. Let us begin the lesson now. Before we start discussing the lesson, I want to ask you a few questions. Have you come across headlines which tell us about disasters? Have you read about these disasters in the newspaper or seen on TV? I am sure you must have. I am going to read a few headlines for you. Pay attention and then we will discuss. Heavy rains cause floods. An earthquake shakes northern region. Landslide leaves many missing. Hurricane damages crops. Tropical typhoon hits the region. Volcanic eruption causes damage. Tsunami warning issued. All these are headlines about natural disasters. You must have seen on TV or read about these disasters, so you know about it. Children who live near the sea, they must have heard about tsunami. Then children who live in the mountains, up in the hills, they must be aware of landslides. Floods are very common in our country. So these are some of the natural disasters that we face. Earthquake is also one of them. There are other natural disasters also. For example, snowstorm, avalanche, forest fire, cyclone, heat wave, drought, all these are natural disasters. We do not have any control over them. But if they happen, then what is common to these disasters? What do we experience? Can you note down a few points? I am giving you 30 seconds to note down the points that what is common to these disasters if they take place. I am sure you must have noted down the points. I will share my points with you. Loss of life. It affects human beings. Loss of property. Financial loss. And most importantly, it impacts on emotional, mental, psychological, and physical well-being of humankind. People are disturbed, they are shattered. Now, if such a thing happens, then what should we do? We have seen government and non-governmental agencies come forward to help people. During such times, we catch a glimpse of different degrees of human endurance, kindness, and exemplary courage in the face of disaster. Now, let us reflect on these questions. My first question is, why is the loss of humans and materials so great? We should nurture life, and our lives are precious. So, the loss is always great when such a disaster happens and it becomes unbearable. What would you do if you heard about an earthquake or landslide or flood in a neighboring town? You know, these types of natural disasters are very common. Earthquake, landslide, floods. So if you hear about it that, you know, in the next town or in the neighboring village, such a thing has happened, so how would you extend help to them? There is no need to go there physically because those people have to be rescued from there. We can help them through government agencies or we can help them through NGOs by, you know, providing food or clothes or financial help. we can do all these things. We can give them help in the form of shelter, medicines, food, clothes, rehabilitation, water, and livelihood. Now, it's not that you are going to do it. The society collectively has to do it. So, it is our responsibility. Now, let us understand a few things about earthquakes now. Which branch of study deals with earthquakes? We have read about earthquakes. Maybe you have experienced also. I have experienced in my life earthquakes. So, which branch of study deals with earthquakes? Pay attention to the options. Meteorology, geology, geophysics, or seismology. Have you been able to spot the answer? Yes, you are right. Seismology. Seismology is the branch of study that deals with earthquakes. I have another question for you. This question also has four options. I'm going to read the question. What is the unit used to measure earthquakes? Tremors per second. Second one, tremor scale. Third, quake meter. Fourth option is Richter scale. Okay, I repeat, what is the unit used to measure earthquakes? Tremors per second, tremor scale, quake meter, or Richter scale? Yes, you have guessed it right. It is Richter scale. So, this lesson is about tsunami. What is a tsunami? What do we understand about tsunami? Tsunami is a powerful wave caused by an earthquake under the sea. Tsunami occurred on 26 December 2004, and this lesson is about that incident. This lesson is divided into three parts. The first part is about Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Second part talks about the experiences from Thailand. And the third part is about the Tamil Nadu coast and Sri Lanka. Let us begin with part 1. Part 1 is stories from the Andaman and Nicobar Islands on 26 December 2004. So let us begin with part 1. As you all know,